When a force is applied to a material, it deforms. Take this sponge, for example. When I apply a force, it loses its shape. But when that force is taken away, it goes back to normal.
So, why does this happen?
Provided that the force does not exceed a critical value, the change is reversible. The particles of the material go back to their original position, and no permanent deformation results. This is called elastic behavior.
To understand a little bit more about elastic behavior and the behavior of different materials, we'll need to understand two new words, stress and strain. So what is stress? Stress is the internal resistance of the material, and it can be defined as the force applied divided by the cross-sectional area where it is applied. What is strain? Strain is a deformation caused by the force applied on the material. It can be defined as the ratio between the change in length and the original length. Hooke's law explains the linear relationship between stress and strain.
An elastic material deforms immediately upon the application of a stress. It maintains a constant strain until the stress is removed, upon which the strain returns back to its original state.
Beyond a certain value of the stress called the proportionality limit, Hooke's law no longer holds. It no longer forms a linear relationship between the stress and the strain. If a material is deformed beyond a certain point known as the elastic limit, that material will no longer go back to its original shape. The deformation is said to be plastic. If the applied stress is removed in the plastic range, the strain does not return to zero. A permanent strain has been produced.
Our knowledge of the structure and nature of the Earth's interior has been derived in large part from studies of seismic waves released by earthquakes. An earthquake occurs in the crust or upper mantle when the tectonic stress exceeds the local strength of the rocks and failure occurs. Away from the region of failure, seismic waves spread out from an earthquake by elastic deformation of the rocks through which they travel. Their propagation depends on elastic properties that are described by the relationship between stress and strain.